What is up, everybody? Janelle here with my Invicta Fighting Championship 10 recap video. I'm only going to do the co-main event and the main event, although it was a great event. You should look it up. First, I want to talk about the new uniforms for the UFC. I want to get your thoughts on this. So, the UFC has signed a deal with Reebok. This is kind of a big deal. It's the first household name that they've signed a big deal with. So, Reebok will be the only sponsor, the only brand to be on all uniforms, male and female. Now, you know how the females, they range from skirts to shorts to pants to onesies. They will still have that freedom as far as the type of gear that they wear. Same thing with the men, shorts, pants, whatever. They will still have that range, but there will only be Reebok on the uniforms. So the way this will break down money-wise is Dana White has says that every single cent will go to the fighters. And the way this will happen is the champions will get the lion's share. And then it will go by rankings. So, you know, the number one, number two, number three will get more of the money than the number seven, eight, nine. This is kind of controversial because, you know, the rankings are picked by the media. So Dana White has said that they will now have a select committee, basically people whose knowledge they trust, whose opinions they trust, to do the rankings still. That leaves room for, you know, some bribery, some manipulation there. I don't know how I feel about the rankings affecting their pay scale. Let me know how you feel about that. Let me know how you feel about Reebok being the only brand to be on the uniforms on the male and female UFC and Invicta FC fighters for the next 6 years. Six-year deal. However, like I said, it's good as far as legitimizing the UFC. This is not a sport of Neanderthals and thugs. This is a legitimate brand, household brand. So in that way, in that light, this is a good thing. Also, you know, the UFC before, I haven't agreed with the way they've kind of gotten between fighters and other sponsorships. That's kind of why Rampage and them part ways. Other fighters, that's the reason why they parted ways. So they've kind of had a rocky history with fighters and sponsorships. So again, let me know your thoughts on that. Now, Invicta FC, the co-main event, we saw Tanya Evinger versus Cindy Dandois. Cindy's been off for 3 years. She has three kids and she's a teacher. She was basically doing the mom, living life thing. She's back now. She's been training with Misha Tate in Las Vegas, top-notch camp. She went on against Tanya Evinger, who was on a six-fight winning streak. Tanya basically dominated this fight. First fight went back and forth for a little bit in the first round. Tanya was able to get a down, ground, and pound. Was even got the crucifix at one point and was lighting her face up. She was saved by the bell. Second round, same thing. Was able to get a down, back and ground and pound. They were going back and forth on the ground a little bit. Tanya had her in a head and arm triangle from the top. Cindy was able to reverse that position. When she was pulled her head out of it, she left her arm in there. Tanya snatched that arm up and tapped her via armbar. Afterwards, you know, the bantamweight championship is vacant in the Invicta FC. Murphy's now in the UFC. Tanya said she's not barking for it. She had made some comments earlier. She said she was a little kind of in a surly mood there, but she'll put whoever fight whoever they put in front of her. I'm saying, Tanya, you're on a 7-fight winning streak. Know your worth. Start barking. You should be in that championship fight. Let me know who else you think should be in that championship fight. Let me know if you think Tanya should be in that championship fight. Because again, the bantamweight championship is vacant. Now, the atomweight championship was on the line in the main event. We saw Michelle Waterson, the karate hottie, take on newcomer, fairly new, took this on short notice, Brazilian, Herica Turbicio. I know I just butchered that. Took her on. This was a dominating performance by the new Invicta FC atomweight champion, Herica Turbicio. And this was a dominating performance for her. She was clearly stronger than Michelle Waterson. She's 4'11". I don't know why she was fighting strawweight 115. This is her weight class. I think she's a champion, so she'll be here. This is her weight class. She was clearly stronger than Michelle Waterson. Michelle Waterson more skilled. However, speed-wise, they were kind of the same. Herica, more aggressive and much stronger. She got the best of those exchanges. She was lighting Waterson up, man. Getting her up against the fence, busting her up, even out in space. She was, again, maybe even a little bit quicker to the punch. Definitely quicker to the punch. Black eye. Blacked her up after the first round. This ended in the third round. She was taking her down on the ground. Michelle was constantly going for submissions. I was kind of nervous there. Michelle could have ended it at any moment because she's constantly going for submissions. But Herica, again, stronger. She was able to muscle her way out of a lot of those submission attempts. Third round, going back and forth. Michelle was trying to stand up. Herica was on top, had her arms clasped up against Michelle. Then she quickly, boom, snapped on a guillotine, pulled guard, snapped on a guillotine, hooks in, tapped her in the third round via guillotine choke. This was a great win, dominating win for Herica. New champ. Who would you like to see her fight next? What do you think is next for Michelle Waterson? She's going to have to go back to the drawing board. This was a dominating victory for Herica Turbicio. So let me know your thoughts on that event. Let me know your thoughts on the new uniforms. Let me know any injury updates. Talk to me in general about life and about fighting. Talk to me. Take care. Goodbye.